Hello friends, once again welcome to Diksha Mission Jaraf. This is our 36th day of Diksha Mission Jaraf. In the past 35 days, we have discussed different topics from our NTN and Paper 1 syllabus. Along with that, we have discussed many set of previous question papers. Especially, we have discussed questions from 2019 December. So in this video also, we'll be continuing the discussion of question from 2019 December. Before that, don't forget about your task number 35, sorry, task number 36. The link for the question paper of task number 36 is given in the YouTube description. At the same time, the answer key for yesterday's task number 35 is also given in the YouTube description. So friends, let's go directly to the question. Okay friends, so as we have already said, we are discussing question paper from 6 December 2019 morning shift. So we are discussing question from the topic data interpretation. So let's go to the questions directly. This is a table that is given. That is, consider the following table that shows the amount of exports in crore from three different companies A, B and C over 3 years in the year 2002 to 2018. So they have given the amount of export in crores between three companies A, B and C. Based on this, you want to answer the five questions. So first question is, what was the difference between the average exports of three companies in 2007 and the average export of three companies in 2012? So that's the first question, is regarding the average exports. Question is, what is the difference between the average exports of three companies in 2017 and the average exports of three companies in 2012? So I will give you some time. Give me your answer in the comment section. Okay, so it's a direct average based question. Okay, so it's a direct question. So we'll try to do the question. So the question is, what is the difference between the average exports? Okay, so firstly, we want to find the export of the company in the year, export of the three companies in the year, export of three companies in the year 2017. Okay, that's the first thing we'll be trying to find. So it's 2017 export is 60 plus 110 plus 90. Okay, you have 60 plus 110 plus 90, which gives you 260. Now you want to find the average export. Average export in the year 2017. Since there are three companies, we have 260 by 3 as the average export. Okay, 260 by 3, you get it as 86.6. So 86.6 is the average export in 2017. Similarly, let's try to find the export of companies. Companies in year, export in year 2012, as asked in the question. 2012. So we have 2012, we have it as 40, 90, and 70. Okay, so we have 40 plus 90 plus 70, which gives you 200. We have 200. Now we want to find the average. Here also we have two companies, so we have 200 by 3, which gives you 66.6. okay, so we got the average export of three companies in the year 2017 as 86.6, and average export of the three companies in the year 2012 was 66.6. Okay, 66.6. Now the question is regarding what is the difference between the average export. So the difference between 86.6 and 66.6, what's being asked in the question. So 66.6 minus 86.6, sorry, 86.6 minus 66.6, you get it as 20. Okay, 20 crore will be the correct answer. Okay, so we have option D, 20 crore is the correct answer. It's a direct question. We'll be finding the average export of three companies 2017 and average export of three companies in 2012, which is subtract and we get the answer. So for this question, you have the option D, rupees 20 crore is the correct answer. Moving to next question. Average annual amount of export during the given period for company B is approximately what percent of the average annual amount of exports for company C? Okay, average annual amount of exports of company B is what percentage of average annual amount of company C? As per this table, there's a question. Okay, so you want to consider the whole table and you want to find the average annual amount of export during the given period of company B. That is given period means during 2012 to 2018. Then you want to find the average company of average amount of export of company C. Then you find that of A is what, B is what percentage of company C. Okay, give me the answer. You can put your answer in the comment section. Okay, so we'll try to do again. It's a simple mathematical question, but you want to do a bit maths. That's it. So the question is average annual amount of export of during the company that of B. So you want to find the average export of company B and you want to find the average export of company C. So you want to find both total and you want to find the average. So for B, we have to add all these values: 90 plus 50 plus 70 plus 70 plus 90 plus 110 plus 150. Okay, you want to add all these values and we want to divide by, since we are finding the average export, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, there are 7 years. Adding this, you get 140, 210, 280, 370, 480, 530,
and 6:30. So you get it as 6:30 by 7. Okay, 6:30 by 7, you have almost it as 90, exact you value 90. So we have the average annual export of company B as 90, and similarly we want to find that of C also. For C you have 70 plus 100 plus 130 plus 100 plus 70 plus 90 plus 110 by 7. So 70 plus 100 we have 170 plus 130 300 400 470 560 and you have 670 as a value. So 670 by 7, you get the value as 95.71. okay, so we directly add all the values of company B and we find the average, we got it as 90, and directly add all the values of company C and we find the value as 95.7. so now let's see how to do. So we got the average export of company B as 90 and company C as, from the previous slide, 95.71. so the question is, average amount of export during the given period for company B is what percent of company C? So this is what percent of this is, that's the question. So 90 by 95.71, we are finding 90 is what percent of 95.71 into 100. So you get the answer as almost approximately 94.03. that's option C as a correct answer. It is a simple question. Directly, firstly we find the average annual export of company B, then we found the average annual export of company C. After that we just find the average annual export of company B is what percentage of the average annual export of company C. So you get it as 94.03. okay, so that's option C as the correct answer. Moving to next question. For which of the following pairs of years the total export from the three companies put together are equal? Okay, in which of the following years are it's equal, that's the question. Okay, give me the answers in the comment section. It's also a direct question. Okay, so it's again a direct question. The question is, which of the following pairs of years the total export from the three companies put together are equal? So let's try to find all the total values, then we can find which are equal. 40 plus 90 we have 130, plus 70 we have it as 200, then we have 70 plus 50 120, plus 100 we have it as 220, Then we have 50 plus 70 120, 120 plus 130 as 250. We have 80 plus 70 as 150 plus 100 as 250. We have 110 plus 90, 200 as 270. So we have 60 plus 110, 170 plus 90 as 260. We have 130 plus 150, 280 plus 110, 390. Okay, so these are the values 200, 220, 250, 250, 270, 260, 390. So we have the equal of 2013 and 2014. Okay, as an equal value. So in the option, it's not 2013 and 2014. It's 2014 and 2015. Okay, 2014 and 2015. We have the option 2014 and 2015 as option D. So it's an easy question. We have option D as the correct answer. So moving to the next question. In how many of the given years were the export from the company A more than its average annual exports over the given years? So the question is, in how many of the given years were the exports from the company A more than its average annual export over the given years? That's the question. It's also a direct and easy question. Give me the answer in the comment section. Okay, we will try to do the question. Question is regarding, in how many of the given years were the export from company A more than its average annual export? So we want to, firstly, we want to find the average annual export of company A. So value of company A, or we can see the average value of company A, 40 plus 70 plus 50 plus 80 plus 110 plus 60 plus 130 plus 130, how many years? We have 7 years, so we want to divide it by 7. So the value we have, 110 plus 50 equal to 160 plus 80, 240 plus 110, 350 plus 60, 410 plus 130. Okay, we have 540 as a value. 540 as a value. So we want to find 540 by 7. Okay, 540 by 7, you get it as 77.14. So we have the average value of 77.14. The question is, in how many of the given years were the export from company A more than its average, more than 77.14? We have 1 year, we have 2 year, we have 3 year. In the year 2015, 2016 and 2018, the value is greater than 77.4. So we have option B, 3 as the correct answer. Also a direct question, just finding the average and just counting the value. Okay, so we have the option B, 3 as the correct answer. Moving to the last question, in which year the absolute difference between the export from company A and B was the minimum? In which year the value was minimum? That's the question. Okay, again, it's an easy question. In which year the absolute difference between the export companies A and B was minimum is a question. So there is no need of doing all the years, because in the year only there are four options. We have 13, 14, 15 and 16. So we'll be dealing with 13, 14, 15 and 16. So what's the difference between 13? 70 minus 50, we have 20. In 14, 70 minus 50, 20. There is absolute difference. Nothing, whether it's positive or negative, doesn't matter. 80 minus 17, we have 10. And 110 minus 90, we have 20. So in the year 2015, the absolute difference is 10. In all other years, whether it's 2013, 2014 or 2016, we have the value as 20. Okay, we have the value as 20. So here we get it as 10. In the year 2015, we have the value as 10. So we have the answer 2015, C as the correct answer, since the question is regarding the value as the minimum. Okay, so that's all about this set of questions.
So that's all about this video discussing 2016-2019 December 6th morning shift question paper, discussing questions from data interpretation topic. I hope you are clear regarding the questions. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. If you would like to know more about Diksha, you can visit our website www.dikshaclassroom.com. Hope you have subscribed to our channel and share with your friends. So thank you, friends. That's all about this video. See you tomorrow.